Yo, what's good? Griffin with 3 here back in the day, and today, guys, we are here for episode number 9 of our Forza Motorsport 7 Let's Play, and I don't even know what car or what championship we are going to do, so today we are going to be taking a look live to just sort of see what we're actually going to pick, because I have no freaking clue, guys. It has been so long since I've actually played in like this, because for the most part, what I've been doing right now is there has been this champion, or not championship, there's been this rivals event, right? And I have been going ham on this thing. I was so close to beating the guy that I have to beat. And then he set a new time. And now I've got another second and a half to go. And it's like, oh my God, where am I going to find that second and a half? I was already having trouble finding the rest of it. So I'm going to keep on going. But I think I don't have much more time. I was planning on making a video for it. In fact, I actually did make a video for it. But the issue is, though, is that my Elgato shit on me and the whole video was just ruined. It looked like I had recorded it on Twitch. And I'm just like, well, crap. So what are we going to choose today? So we got Breakout Open, we got Formula E, SUVs, Grand Tours, Rally Heroes. Let's do Grand Tours. Now, this event here, guys, this whole thing would take 2 episodes. Or 3 or 4 episodes. So I don't know. Maybe what I'll do for that is I might do it on my own. And just sort of like maybe put some highlights in it. Like if there's anything that cool that happens. I mean, I'll record the whole thing. But it's going to be a long ass video. And I'm just like, oh, goddamn. Unless you guys want to see the whole freaking thing. I don't even know it, guys, but there's 69 laps of this I have to do, which I'm fine with doing 69 laps. I mean, fuck, look at this Rivals event. I probably have done 150 laps so far just trying to get up there, and I can't. I'm at 147.6 around the Circuit of the Americas, and it's just, it is hard. I'm getting tired of looking at a Formula One car going around the Circuit of Americas and me constantly losing. I finally beat Mechberg, though. I'm happy about that. I finally beat Mechberg, so now I'm about a tenth of a second ahead of him. And now we've got this guy from the IndyCar driver, and I just cannot beat him. So I'm thinking Grand Tours. That sounds like a good choice.
Hatchbacks and sedans. These cars leave behind that whole taboo of bumping, trading paint, and dents. They've been rebuilt to be aggressive on the track. So don't be surprised if you finish a race with scrapes and scars.
Okay, so I just realized that my mic on my, or my volume on my TV was up a little too loud. So we do have one. We got a Volvo. Question is this Volvo going to do any good? So we're going to try our damnedest, guys, on this series. I don't know if we're going to do well at all. We might get our asses handed to us. They might mollywop us. But it looks like our first race is this, this is Dubai. Okay, it's Dubai. I'm actually got a little bit of practice in at Dubai. I've been doing not too terrible. But man, guys, these hot laps that I've been doing, they are just killing me. And I was hoping to have a video out today about the hot laps, but I don't know. Because I think the hot laps are actually over tomorrow. I think you only have until tomorrow to actually finish it up. They never actually put like an expiration date on it, so I don't know, but I'm actually kind of happy right now because today is a Monday, and I didn't have to work because it's a holiday. Woohoo! Yeah! No working on holidays. Yeah. I'm happy about it, except that tomorrow when I go to work, I'm going to be extremely tired. It's going to feel like Monday, and I'm going to be like, where am I going to be here? I'm actually yawning, like, Jesus, it's 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and I woke up like 4 hours ago. I know, guys, I got up a little late, but yeah, so, hashtag life of a YouTuber. I was up all night last night trying to get these hot laps in so I could finally beat this time, because last night, his time was a 147.5, now it's a 146.0, and it's like, God damn it, I am not going to be able to do this, am I? Volvo's actually doing pretty good. I've never done this reverse one, though. Ooh, it's quite dark in here. I first, and you know what I bet? I bet already know what happens. What's going on is that it's already got moved up down into average because I restarted the game. I hate how it does that. Every time I turn on the game, it won't save that setting. I wonder if other like YouTubers and other people have been having this problem. Guys, if you're having a similar problem, let me know down in the comment section down below because I am getting... Okay, what is going on, man? What is going on? I don't have anything else running. And... My Elgato is like telling me I've got problems. Like, I mean, this is a good computer, guys. What is going on? Maybe it's because I think there's like an update on my computer I have to do still. Like it's updating like every goddamn day right now, and I don't understand. There's not that many updates. And then of course, there's some programs that HP has on here that I want to get rid of. And unfortunately for them, unfortunately for me, I don't know how to actually get rid of them. Because they're like, hey, I'm security that you already don't use anyway because there's already another security wall on here that you don't need me for. And, oh, hey, Edge is faster than Chrome. It's like, I don't care. Because literally every time I go to open Chrome, Microsoft Edge has to stroke its ego and be like, well, I'm faster than Chrome now. You should use me. It's like, Edge, I don't want to use you, though. Literally. I mean, I don't know if you guys have seen that meme for Rick and Morty, and it's got the butter robot, and it goes, or not the butter robot. It's the butter robot with Internet Explorer or Microsoft Edge on it, and it says, what is my purpose? And Rick just looks at it and it's like, you installed Chrome. Because Chrome is, guys, the ultimate one. Because, one, I don't want to use Bing, because Bing is garbage. I'm sorry, Microsoft. Bing is garbage. Like, literally, half the time, it's like, what is the weather today? If I go on Google, it's going to tell me exactly what I need to know right on the home screen, so I don't actually have to click on a link. If I go to Bing, well, fuck. I'm going to get something like, what was the weather in 1975 today? And then I'll get like, oh, God, guess my controller just shit on me right there. And what else am I going to get? I'm going to get, like, dinosaurs ravaging the Earth. A climate change proven or something like that. And it just because I said, what is the weather today? And it's like, God damn it, Bing. Stop it. I don't even care. Okay, I'm so not used to this backwards track. It is weird to me. It is really, really weird. Oh my God, look at that plane. So here we go, guys. We're only in second right now. Not good. Not good. Come on, man. Come on. Hit that wall a little bit too hard. Oh. Maybe we'll have to go see if we can find a livery for this Volvo, because I'm not too keen on the blue and yellow, because you guys know, I'm an Ohio State Buckeye fan, and blue and yellow is the color of my enemies. So maybe we'll have to find one that maybe they replace it with, like, red and gray. I don't know. So, God, I hate Michigan. I'm sorry if there's, like, a Michigan fan watching right now, because I'm sure they're... There's got to be one person right out here that, you know, they like Michigan. Maybe they're not watching the live, or not the live stream, the Let's Play, but I'm sure they have watched, like, one of my videos before, and just, they're going to be like, yeah, Gurr's Ohio State fan, I don't like Gurr now. Because, guys, the rivalry is, it is real. It is real. Like, people have got killed over this thing. That's how serious they take it. Now, that's a little extreme. Like, I'm not gonna go out and murder someone because they're a Michigan fan, but I will chance in their face, because I was actually it's funny, you know, a couple months ago I was down in Disney World, although actually, holy shit, it's almost been a year since I was actually down in Disney, and on the bus in front of us was a guy wearing a Michigan shirt, and my dad had to tell me, don't you dare, because I just started going, and we don't give a damn for the whole state of Michigan, the whole state of Michigan, the whole state of Michigan. And my dad's like, oh God, stop it. No, Now we're drifting this ball, though. I actually like, though, how in Forza Motorsport 7, when your tires get hot, you actually start drifting more instead of, like, in Forza Motorsport 5, when you would try and do it, what would happen is you would just crash into a wall. Instead, it's easy to control now, which I like that. That makes it so much easier. And I need to change gears out of first. What the hell am I doing? What the hell am I doing, guys? And we are getting our asses kicked considering the fact that we're on average. Maybe we're not on average, or maybe it's just that I'm all that bad because I'm so used to right now driving Formula One cars. Because that's all I've been doing. Hit some blue and yellow tires. There we go. Not too shabby, not too shabby. Alright, here we go. We are about to finish up, but I do need to check on the Drivatar difficulty because I haven't been using Drivatars recently. I've just been... It's been Rivals, straight up. And god damn it, Elgato, it's... So, right now, I have my Elgato set to 60 frames per second, right? Because this game is a 60 frames per second game. And right now, it's telling me that I'm only getting 53. Which, I know that's still, like, pretty damn good, but it's like... Every time I see, like, little warnings like that, like, hey, you're not getting 60. It concerns me a little bit. It concerns me that maybe something is going on that I need to, or like this video is going to end up being like shitty or something weird is going to happen. I don't know. I don't even know, guys. It's just, it worries me. It worries me. So here we go, though. We are on to our next race. We pick up a nice, yeah, we got to be on just average. We do level up. As you guys notice, my level is actually now 43. That is how much hot lapping I have been doing. I started out at, like, level, like, 30, and I've gained, like, 13 levels just from doing all this hot lapping. So, let's see here. What do we want to pick? What do we want to pick? There's an Alfa Romeo driving suit, a Formula E car, and 50,000 credits. I'm going to go with the driving suit. You know, I've been picking the driving suits more because I kind of want to just get it to the point where if I'm going to get a driving suit, it's going to give me a legendary one. So, more recently, I've been picking more of the driving suits. So, just to see how they go. Alfa Romeo has been making cars since 1910 and racing them since 1911. Cool fun fact! I was hoping for a little bit more than that, but... And then we got a Canada driving suit. And the Alfa Montreal. Oh my god, guys. And the next one, whenever we level up next, that is going to be a nice little story for me to tell. If I can actually think of it. If I can think of it, because there was something in one of our videos that we did. Because the Alfa Montreal, I think, is kind of new-ish to Forza. I maybe it was in Forza 4. There was something about the Alfa Montreal that I actually did a specific topic about in a video. I can't remember for the life of me, though. So, we're going to Circuit de Catalunya, Grand Prix Circuit. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to turn up my TV's volume this time. Hopefully, it's not coming over the mic too much. Because we're going to see right here. I'm going to go quiet for a second. Okay, so it does come through a little bit, and my voice is way louder than it. So I don't think we should have any real problems whatsoever. Plus, I don't think there's too much of a lag, so everything should match up pretty evenly, I'm hoping. I just want it so that I can hear. So, yeah. We haven't had any issues on 4, and I only turned it up 2 points so I can hear a little bit better. So here we go. Come on. You know what I didn't check? I didn't check difficulty. Oh, god damn it. Can't check it now. All these Volvos, man. All of them. I like that blue vinyl, though. Or that blue livery. There we go. We are over the first. We got out of that pack. This Volvo's actually doing the work. Come on. It feels so slow, though. I've been driving these Formula One cars, and they have just been, like... Or, they're probably not even Formula One. They're Indy cars. What am I... I keep calling it Formula One. I know it's Indy. But, man. This car just feels so slow. Like, I'm feeling like I'm braking, and it's taking forever, and it's... Oh, my God. Come on, man. Come on. We only got two laps this though, surprisingly, so I don't, it's interesting. I mean, shoot, we can't even get like a good hot lap in because we're already off to the races. But I feel like we gotta be just on average right now, and that's kinda crappy because the real challenge is on expert, and I mean, it's just, it's just bad. Now, if anybody here is like, you know, in the last section was noticing how terrible my gear changes were, yeah, that was because I couldn't hear. That's why I turned up my TV volume, so I don't know. There are so many different little things that I feel like I might be able to get away with here in a second, because one of the things that we noticed the other day is that if I'm live streaming and I have open Xbox Live Party, it'll actually record the Xbox Live Party. At least what I think. I'm not entirely sure on this, but I was checking it, and I don't know. I'm gonna have to go back and look at the video. So it's just, this has just been a weird deal, guys. Getting this Elgato, it's a whole new learning curve, and I'm trying to figure things out so that we can have like good high quality content, because at least now we've got this 1080p 60 shit, which is so much better than our 480p garbage that we had. And I'm trying to keep it at 1080p, but sometimes I do think it'll drop a little bit. And if we do live streams, I'm thinking I'm going to try and record it just in like 720p, so I'm not like, you know, really like trying to stretch my computer's limitations. And then it'll probably try and stream it in like 480. I don't really know yet, guys. It's a bad situation with my internet. Like, I have good internet, guys. Like, it's not even that bad. Like, I'm paying so much money for my internet. And the thing is, though, is that they're like, oh, yeah, we can only give you 2 megabits per second upload. And it's like, but I'm paying for 25. And it's like, yeah, you're paying for 25 download. You're not paying for upload. And it's like, what the hell is that about? I need a faster upload speed. If you would give me the 25 megabits per second upload, honestly, I would be in pretty good shape. Like, I mean, my parents, you know, they had they only had 6 megabit per second internet speed. And we were able to stream it in, you know, 720p. So, honestly, all I need is like 4 more megabits per second. And honestly, we would have such better high quality. Because I was able to stream in like good high quality definition. You know, 720p, we'd have a glitch here or there. You know, nothing too serious, though. And now I have 2 megabits per second upload. It's like, how can they get away with shit? And then they also offer services in, like, bigger cities where they have 1 gigabyte speed that literally costs only about $10, $20 more than what I'm paying. That's crazy, guys. God, I hate it. And someone's going to say just move, and it's like, it's not that simple, guys. I can't just move yet. So at some point, it may get to that point where I could just be like, well, I'm just going to move. But right now, it's not that way. So not that way. So actually, it looks like if we actually get first place in all the rest of these championships, we will actually finish our breakout championship series and get to move on to the next one. Now, I'm going to have to sit there and I'm going to have to do my 69 laps of Spa, which is going to be painful. Although there is one way I could cheat it. It didn't say anything about difficulty. And if someone really, really wanted to, all they got to do is set it to super easy and literally just hold down the controller the whole time. That's all they got to do. So here we go. Let's go on to our next race. Loading up. So we are going to Sonoma Raceway. I'm trying to remember which one Sonoma is. I don't know. Have we been to Sonoma yet? I'm sure that once I get on the track, I'll recognize it. I hope anyway. Because there are some tracks in this game that, you know, I feel like I've never, ever been on. And then there's some that's like, oh, nostalgia. And it's just like, man, come on. Sonoma does not sound familiar, though. We'll see how this goes. Okay, you know what? I forgot to do driver char difficulty. So we're on highly skilled. So we're actually up there a little bit, but let's move it up on to expert, because we've gotten first in two races. So this Volvo is actually doing us not too bad. I was afraid that we were on average coming in like that place. But we were on highly skilled, so it's not as bad as I was afraid of. Not as bad as I was afraid of. So let's see here. We're going to go ahead and start our race up. Come on, man. Come on, Volvo. Do us a miracle here. We need a miracle. Or maybe it's just all that hot lapping has gotten me really, really good, even though I was like crashing like crazy earlier. Like, I mean, in that last race, we actually ended up... Oh, I know Sonoma now. Yes. See, like I said, we haven't been here yet in this Let's Play, but I do know Sonoma, definitely. Oh, yeah, this is a little bit more of a challenge. We're going to use that BMW as a little bit of a brake right there. And look, he's taking that inside line, he's taking it away from us, so that now we can't actually use it. Come on, man, come on, why are you doing that to me? Why are you doing that to me? That wasn't really smart, but it actually paid off a little bit. Because I don't know if you guys actually saw what just happened there. And I noticed that everybody's got just a crown above their name. Which leads me to believe that the Forza servers might be down, because I'm not seeing any names whatsoever. So... That's a little bit of a worry. But maybe they're, you know, finally patching the glitch, or maybe they're doing something else, like maybe they're bringing us the auction house. Because, guys, where the hell is the auction house? Okay, look at this. All right. This pisses me off right here. They can have Toyota as a sponsor. So Toyota is still paying them money. But unfortunately, we can't have Toyota cars. Like, okay, that is ridiculous. Why is this even in the game? This just pisses me off right here. This just pisses me off. In fact, I'm probably going to make a separate video literally just about the big old Toyota sign at Sonoma. Like, what the hell? Come on, Forza. What is going on? You should have just... When Toyota said, hey, we're not going to put any of your cars in the game, we are just going to... But we want you to put our advertisement sign. You should have said, no, we're going to replace your Toyota sign with a Mazda sign or something like that. Hashtag Mazda M6. If you guys don't get that, literally probably the number one comment I've gotten here in the last couple days is there was a... I made that video on the glitch, and somebody... People just keep on commenting, like, did he seriously just take Mazda M6? And it's like, yeah, I said Mazda M6. Like, there's a comma in between them because there was a Mazda racing suit beneath it, if you'd actually watch the freaking video. Jesus Christ. So, I don't know. It's one of those things, it's just like, okay, read the comments, because literally you're about, like, the 50th person to say it. I'm getting tired of just responding, like, if you actually go back and watch the scene, there's a Mazda driving gear just beneath the news. More like Mazda driving gear, BMW M6, and credits. I thought that was pretty ambiguous, but I guess not, because you're so stupid that you can't understand it. So, sorry, I'm calling people out right now. It's just, I shouldn't be. I apologize to you guys. I'm not trying to call you out. It's just getting a little bit annoying. I hope you all understand. Man, it's been an annoying comment here on the channel. So let's go ahead. I need to figure out how to get that turn actually, like, proper, because that is a very, very sharp turn that I could not make with a controller. I bet you that's, like, a turn that you can only be made with a racing wheel. And one day I would like to have a racing wheel, guys. Don't get me wrong. I would love to get a racing wheel one day. But right now, one, it's too expensive. And two, I have nowhere to put it. absolutely nowhere to put a racing wheel. Because my house is kind of small. I mean, maybe if I get like an office eventually, things will work out a little bit better. And whoa, we're only in 7th place. Okay, we got another lap, but damn, we need to get going. Come on, let's go, Volvo. We need to catch up a little bit. 7th place or 6th place is not good. We're sliding a little bit. But this car feels so damn slow. Like, I know it's not slow. Like, I mean, it actually kind of is. Now that I'm looking at the speedometer, like, it is a little bit slow. Now, if I had this car, I would say, holy shit, this is so fast! If I had it in real life. Okay, so we made that turn a little bit easier, but we had to brake significantly more than I would have liked to. Come on, Volvo, come on. Well, it looks like we got a little bit complacent. We would have maybe caught the next guy on the next lap, but I think overall, like, that it spread out way too much for us to actually catch up. 6th place, though, God. Damn, that sucks. That sucks, because that means that we're going to have to do something else here to actually get into the champion, to finish the championship up. Oh, man. All right. So we're still in first by 25 points. Oh, my God, guys. See, on highly skilled, we get first. On expert, which is 20% more credits bonus afterwards, we get 6th. So, I don't know. We'll try one more race on expert. But if we lose, we're moving back down to highly skilled. Because this is getting ridiculous. It's like moving up from highly skilled, which is kind of like, eh? Like, I mean, that's they seem a lot easier. Like, the difference between average and highly skilled is very small. But then the difference between highly skilled and expert is, like, extreme. Now, it could be that maybe I'm just a really bad driver right now. I don't know. But we have to score. In order for us to do this, I think we could get away with getting second on each one of the next two races. So, we're going to do one more race today, open up our prize crate, and be done with it. But, man, oh, man, come on. Mazda Laguna... Oh, God, guys. And you guys have seen how much this car is sliding everywhere, right? Right? I don't know. I don't even know it. I don't even know it. Here we go, though. We're going to try it. Expert setting. Alright, so we're up into 4th, kinda right there along with, oh, we drop back here into 5th, because that BMW got the inside line, and he's just breaking in front of us, let us get past you, man! When we're faster, be courteous. Get out of my way, dick. Alright, come on. We need a good position, because we need to score, like, I think it's 800 points is what it said. Hold on, we got to back up there. I lost a little bit of control on my controller. Hold on. There we go. All right, man, come on. Oh, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. All right, we're coming up to the corkscrew. Use that BMW as a brake. Come on. Oh, God, the Audi. No, what are you doing, man? What are you doing? That's what you get, dick. Come on, man. Come on. I hate being like that guy. I hate being that guy. But we're into second, which is pretty good for us. We've had to rewind twice now because stupid Audi being a dick just ramming us into like the sidewall. Because like it feels like they just do that shit on purpose now. Like, you, if you're like trying to pass them, they'll be like, well, nobody gets to actually pass me. And they'll just ram you off the road. Like, they will purposely, like, ruin any chance they have a victory just to run you off the road. It's crazy. Like, you guys saw with that Audi back there. I was trying to pass him, and then he started going into my lane. And then instead of, you know, trying to turn off of me, he just kept turning into me. To just, you know, basically run me off the road. And I guess, I mean, that is a typical Audi driver, but I mean, come on, man, come on. Actually, no, that'd be more of a typical BMW driver, but I definitely need to do something with this Volvo, guys, for the next episode, because there's something off with it. All right, come on, Volvo, let's go. I mean, it doesn't feel like it's firmly planted. Oh, yes, though. But, I mean, it is doing halfway decent. It just doesn't feel right to me. You know what I'm saying? Like, the car just doesn't feel like a car that I want to drive a lot. Even though it's doing, put in the work. Here we go. And this should be our last lap here. Cover it up. Come on, man. Come on. Let's do it. Oh, God damn. Come on, man. Come on. What are you doing? Like, you see that? It feels like the back end is just a little bit too heavy. And it just wants to slide. I mean, it feels like it would be a halfway decent drifter. Because it just feels like it wants to slide. Like that. And you guys saw earlier when we were on Dubai. You know, we got our tires on, and that thing was just sliding like crazy. And it was holding, it was under control. But I mean, it was just crazy. It was just crazy. And you know what? Maybe in the next episode, what we'll do is we'll actually take this Volvo out, and we will try and drift it. We'll try and drift it. That would be an interesting thing to see, because it feels like it could drift. Like, it's a race car, but it just feels drifty. I don't get it. You know, it's not even a car that I would normally purchase. It was just one that I happened to have won out of, like, I think, was it a prize crate or something I got this out of? Was it a level up? It might have been a level up reward. I might have got it for, like, real cheap or something. Early on. Because right now we're level 43. So, I don't know. Right. Oh, crap. I accidentally let go of the control there. There we go, cross the line, and we have our victory. A 138-146 was our best lap. Is that the best lap out of everyone? I don't think so. I think that Yeah. Right there, that BMW, 136. There was another Volvo that had 136. 37s. Oh, God, yeah. We were kind of dicks to get a 138. It also could be that maybe that 138 was just a clean lap, and that's why it counted. But, I mean, man. Man, oh, man. All right. So we only got 350 points for getting first? What happened to 450 like we were getting earlier? Oh, no, man. Okay, something just happened. I don't know what just happened, but I think it's loading into the next race or something here. Oh, nope, credits. Yep. Hey, it went a little fast for what I was expecting. Oh, God, we're only 200 credits or 200 XP away from leveling up. Man, man, that sucks right there. That sucks just a little bit. So, oh, man, I keep forgetting this. They need to have an exit button here. Like, it should be, like, press B to exit to menu. Like, that is something that needs to happen. I don't know. There's just all these little things that should have been added. And we need to get up to 5,000 points on this race. So we need to somehow get 450. If this race gives us 450 points and we can pull off a first, then we complete the championship. But if it only gives us 350 like last time, we'll be 100 points away from finishing. And that's crazy. That is crazy. So all right, now we're back here at Silverstone. We're going to exit out of this shit and just go open up our prize crate real quick. Because we're already 6 minutes over time. Like, I don't even know. I didn't even know it. That's the one thing that I don't like about racing, is that you can't just be like, oh, hey, it's 30 minutes, we better stop now, yeah. It's like, you gotta go until, like, your whole race is over. Or just start editing things out and do, like, one championship per video. And I don't like doing that. We'll have a new car to use in the next video, but, man. Man, all right, here we go. Let's go ahead, find ourselves a prize crate, see what we can get. Come on, big money no whammy, guys. Big money no whammy. I'm not going to go ahead. In my crate video, I was rubbing the crate, and people were like, you're wasting too much time. Just open up the giggity goddamn crate. So I guess I'm just going to open up the giggity goddamn crate. Hit that like button for good luck, guys. Come on. Oh, we got something super rare. We got a pit crew. Oh! Super rare award badge, come on, get rid of that shit. That is stupid. Nobody wants it. Get it out of here. Get him out of here. We don't want that. I saw the super rare, I'm thinking, oh man, we're gonna get a super rare car. Nope, we get a 2016 Subaru. Number 75 WRX. Oh god, that kind of sucks. And then we got 30,000 credits because we already own the pit crew one. And then we got burnout, full simulation damage, reach at least 225, 70% credit, and 100 or 1500 experience. But anyway, though, that is where we're going to go and wrap it up for today. If you guys want to, you can make sure to follow me on Twitter and Instagram at twitter.com/grip413 and instagram.com/grip413. And as well, if you like this video, go ahead and make sure to hit that like button down below for us, because you guys already know your support is so greatly appreciated. And make sure to subscribe for more videos coming out all the time. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out.